Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
The topic that we're doing is reciprocating pumps, and today we'll be looking at indicator diagrams. So this is a very important part when you when you're studying reciprocating pumps. You should be always be aware of this topic, the indicator diagram. So we'll see in detail what indicator diagram is, what it tells you about the reciprocating pumps. So let's first of all see what indicator diagram is. It is nothing but a graphical representation of the pressure versus the stroke, or you can say the crank angle. So we all know that as the piston moves, the pressure changes along the cylinder, along the length of the cylinder, and we'll be plotting the pressure, the change of pressure as the crank moves. So different angles of crank, we'll see what the pressure is at different strokes. So that is nothing but the indicator diagram. So it tells a lot to you, it tells a lot about the reciprocating pumps. So we'll see how it works, and we'll see the graph, and the pressure is plotted along the vertical axis, that is the y-axis, and the angle, that is the crank angle, is plotted along the x-axis. So as you can see, I have drawn two vertical, one vertical and one horizontal line. The vertical line is nothing but the pressure line, and this is nothing but the value of the stroke angle, theta. So the origin is nothing but zero pressure, zero angle. The pressure increases along this, those angle increases along this. So as you can see, a 0 degrees when the piston is at the extreme left side. Now the piston starts sucking in, it moves, the angle increases, and this is the point at which the suction stroke ends at 180 degree. Now after the suction stroke ends, the piston again starts moving towards the right side, and now it compresses the water. This line, as you can see here, the horizontal line, is nothing but the absolute zero pressure. Absolute zero pressure is nothing but perfect vacuum, and this line is nothing but the atmospheric pressure. Now we all know that initially, before the pump starts working, before the pump is working, it will be at atmospheric level. That is at A. So now just imagine that the pump has started sucking water. For that, the pressure has to be a little less than the atmospheric pressure, because only when the pressure is less than the atmospheric pressure, the water from the reservoir will start moving up because of vacuum created. There has to be some partial vacuum created in it. So when the pump starts moving towards the left side, the suction stroke, the pressure reduces instantaneously. We'll assume that the pressure reduces instantaneously to a particular value, which is nothing but HS. So the head through which the water has to be lifted, the pressure, the vacuum head, is not has to be equal to HS. So we'll assume that as the suction stroke begins, the pressure instantaneously drops to HS. The pressure head instantaneously drops to HS. So let's plot the graph for pressure versus theta, the indicator diagram. So as I said earlier, before the reciprocating pump is working, everything is atmospheric. So the point A is nothing but the atmospheric pressure. Now imagine that the pump has started working, the suction has just started, and I'll assume that the instantaneously the pressure drops, it becomes partial vacuum, and the vacuum is nothing but the vacuum head is nothing but equal to HS, that is suction head. Only when the vacuum pressure head is equal to HS, the water will be pulled up. So at 180 degree of crank angle, the suction stops. Now the water has been sucked inside the cylinder. Now we'll assume that the pressure instantaneously changes to H, the pressure has to increase now, because after vacuum it has created, the water has been pulled inside the pump, and now you have to compress the water, and as a as you compress the water, there will be pressure rise, and the pressure rise is well above the atmospheric pressure. So we'll assume that instantaneously the pressure rises. So the pressure rises instantaneously to the point D, and the delivery stroke has started now. The water is starting getting, the water has been, is getting compressed, and it has been simultaneously delivered from the pump outside. So this is how it looks like. So the amount of vacuum head that has to be created inside the pump is, should be equal to HS, because only then the water will be pumped. Now the amount of pressure that has to be created after suction stroke should be equal to HD, only then the water will be pulled out. So these lengths has to be HS and HD. So this is nothing but the indicator diagram, theoretical indicator diagram, or you can say ideal indicator diagram for a reciprocating pump. So it's very important to understand different points A, B, C, D, then lastly it is E. So it starts with A, the pressure drops instantaneously by head HS, then the suction stroke begins. BC is nothing but a suction stroke. Then it instantaneously the pressure increases to point D, then the delivery stroke begins. And after point E, the water has been completely delivered out, and again it comes to point A. So this is how the pressure variation takes place. This is how HD and HS has to be worked out. So that was all about the indicator diagram of reciprocating pumps. I hope you've understood this topic. Thank you so much.